Hello everyone, my name is Frank van Ruitenbeek. The title of this presentation is Shannon Entropy and Hydrothermal Processes. It shows the results of a study on hydrothermally altered rocks that I've carried out together with my co-authors. The aim of the study was to apply concepts from information theory, including the Shannon entropy, to investigate the effect of hydrothermal processes on rocks from an information theory perspective, and the measurement and quantification of these effects. This schematic shows that the rocks that are affected by hydrothermal processes modify their composition and become altered. And the reason why we study the effects of hydrothermal processes is because they are possibly linked to the origin of life and they lead to the formation of mineral deposits, so they are worth studying. In this slide, I present one of the highlights of the study, so you can determine if this presentation is of interest to you. This figure shows two different Shannon entropies calculated from rock sample analysis. The one on the x-axis is called the spectral Shannon entropy, which is calculated from infrared reflected spectra. The other on the y-axis is called the chemical Shannon entropy, which was calculated from measurements of the chemical composition. There are two clusters of hydrothermally altered rock samples that have significantly lower Shannon entropies than their unaltered equivalents, which are represented here by the dashed horizontal and vertical lines. This means that the altered rocks show higher degrees of ordering with respect to their chemical composition and reflected spectra. The composition and spectra are less randomly distributed than those of the unaltered rocks. Why this is important and what we can conclude from this, I'll explain. It is in the remainder of this presentation. First, something about hydrothermal processes. This slide shows the kind of hydrothermal processes that I'm considering in this study. These are processes where water circulates through a seafloor where hot magma, an intrusion, drives fluid convection, and where we can distinguish water recharge zones and fluid discharge zones. By the interaction of fluids and rock, the composition of the rock changes. Primary minerals break down and new minerals are formed. The photo in the middle shows an active hydrothermal discharge zone, as we can observe at, for instance, mid-oceanic ridges. The photos on the right show early life fossils that are typically spatially associated with hydrothermal systems. Here you can see what hydrothermally altered rocks look like. The outcrop on the left shows broken and bleached rock. Composition of the volcanic rock in the lower right was changed to an assemblage of quartz and fine-grained muscovites. The upper right shows a microscopic view of the same rock of a feldspar crystal that has been altered to fine-grained minerals. So in the study, we used the Shannon entropy for the calculation on whole rock analytical data. It quantifies the amount of uncertainty of a probabilistic choice system, according to the formula here, which is well known. And in this formula, we consider the number of possibilities in this choice system and the probability of each possibility. Here you can see how the chemical Shannon entropy was calculated from the chemical compositional data of the rock samples. For each of the probability distributions, the x-axis shows the chemical elements. On the y-axis, the concentration or probability of each element in a rock is shown. In the case that we only have silicium in a rock sample, the chemical Shannon entropy has a value of zero, as is shown in the left graph. There is no uncertainty with regard to its composition. In the case that the elements are present in equal proportions, the chemical Shannon entropy has a maximum value, which represents maximum uncertainty here shown on the right. The decreasing uncertainty from right to left can be interpreted as an increase in the chemical sorting of the rock. In this slide, you can see how the spectral Shannon entropy was calculated from the infrared reflected spectra of the rock samples. The figure on the left shows the reflectance of infrared radiation in the wavelength range between 1300 and 2450 nanometers by a rock that contains the mineral muscovite. Typical here are the absorption features, for instance, this one. After normalization and conversion to absorption, which is 1 minus the reflectance, we can calculate the Shannon entropy of this distribution. The muscovite reflectance spectrum has a spectral entropy value of 10.174. The hypothetical reflectance curve on the right represents maximum uncertainty and has a value of 10.230. The decrease in uncertainty towards the left can, similar to that in the previous slide, be interpreted as a form of sorting, in this case sorting of absorption values, of absorption features, sorry. This is the same slide that I showed in the beginning of the presentation. It shows the spectral entropy of the x-axis and the chemical entropy on the y-axis. The points in the plot represent hydrothermally altered rock samples, which cluster in two groups showing different types of alteration minerals. The quartz sericite altered rocks have lower Shannon entropies than the chloride quartz altered rocks. Entropies of unaltered rocks are represented by the dashed horizontal lines and a vertical line. Interesting is to note that the chemical entropy of the unaltered rocks decreases with the increase in silicium content of the rock, going from mafic rocks such as this basalt to felsic rocks such as the rhyolite, and which also reflects a progressive fractionation from mafic to felsic rocks. This figure shows that the hydrothermally altered rocks, especially the quartz sericite altered rocks, have undergone sorting of chemical elements and absorption features. In these plots of the mean chemical composition of the different groups of rocks in this study, one can see why the hydrothermally altered rocks have lower chemical Shannon entropy values. Silicium contents are higher, and sodium, calcium, magnesium, and iron contents are generally lower than in the unaltered groups of rocks. The unaltered groups of rocks are represented here by basalts, andesites, dacites, and rhyolites. The alteration of the two groups of altered rocks lead to probability distribution shapes with lower Shannon entropy values. This figure shows why the infrared reflectance spectra of hydrothermally altered rocks produce low spectral Shannon entropy values. The two mean spectra of the quartz sericite altered rocks and the chloride quartz altered rocks, shown here, they have deeper absorption features, the troughs in the curves, than those of the unaltered rocks. Deep and few absorption features result in low entropy values. The absorption of infrared radiation at narrow wavelength ranges causes molecular vibrations at restricted wavelengths, and therefore at restricted frequencies. This is important to remember. We can calculate the difference in Shannon entropies between the altered rocks and their unaltered precursors by the formula in the lower right. In this figure, the difference in spectral and chemical entropies are plotted along the x and y axis, respectively. The two clusters of altered rocks are clearly shown here, the unaltered rocks plot in the origin. The change in Shannon entropy is the direct result of the modification of the chemical and mineralogical composition of the rock by hydrothermal processes. This could be interpreted as a quantification of the effects of the processes on the rocks. Could we also interpret this as a form of information imposed on the rock? We are looking here at a reduction in the uncertainty in the chemical and spectral probability distributions. When we consider the hydrothermal system with a heat source and fluid convection in which the hydrothermal alteration occurred, we can observe the following relationship between heat and the Shannon entropies. Heat drives the hydrothermal fluid convection, which causes destabilization of wall rock. This leads to a change in chemical and mineralogical composition and ultimately to decreasing Shannon entropies. So we can now make the following conclusions. One, the Shannon entropy can be used for the identification of hydrothermally altered rocks. Two, Shannon entropy is an indicator of sorting processes in hydrothermal systems and can quantify these, the effects of sorting. And three, hydrothermal processes provide a natural mechanism for transforming energy from heat to increased order in rock. There are also still some open questions that have not been solved yet. The first question is, there a relationship between low Shannon entropy rocks in hydrothermal environments and occurrences of early life forms that typically maintain a low thermodynamic entropic state? The second question, can the Shannon entropy act as a proxy for thermodynamic statistical entropy? For instance, the entropy formulated by Boltzmann. And the third question, does the relationship between molecular vibrations at specific frequencies and molecular vibrations in the rock fluid interface in hydrothermal systems influence the habitability of early life environments? Okay, that's the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye.